getting to travel to all different kinds of cities all over the world and meeting fans every weekend and people coming up and telling us how awesome we are. It's pretty cool.
I agree.
It doesn't get much better than that. Travel around the world for free and meet fans.
Yeah.
It's not a bad gig.
Hardest thing.
We worked really long hours, 12 hours, sometimes more. And we'd finish filming and then have to go and do ADR, which was all our voiceover work. So the days were really long, but we were in our early 20s, so.
Yeah. Right, exactly.
And we're still in our early 20s.
So yeah, right.
You both appeared in the 25th anniversary episode.
Yep.
How was it to come back and don the suit again?
I thought it was a real honor to be asked because they have so many rangers to choose from. So the fact that they chose us to come back was really nice. And
yep.
The fans were disappointed that they didn't have any of the earlier cast members in the one they did for Megaforce. So I'm glad they listened to the fans and brought us back this time.
Yeah. I really had a lot of fun with that because that was the first time in 20 years that I had been on the set of Rangers. So
yeah.
It was pretty cool. There were other opportunities and I missed them for circumstances, you know, I wasn't able to do it, but this time around I did. So it was very, very cool.
Yeah, we had fun.
What do you think the timeless appeal of this franchise is? Why do you think it means so much to so many different people?
Well, there's a lot of things actually, but I mean, this is what I say, like, you know what? Picture yourself as a four-year-old kid, right? And all of a sudden you're watching the screen and then a big giant lightning bolt comes down the middle of the screen and all this explosions start happening and this rock music starts playing and then you see robots and bright colors and people doing karate and aliens and monsters all in the span of 22 minutes, you know? It's pretty exciting for a kid, you know? So I think, and then you couple that with the group of people so diverse and they learn how to work as a team and there's always a good message at the end. I think it's just a good formula, you know? And so that's why they keep it the same all the time. And I think it's pretty good and it seems to work. And I think that's part of its longevity, I think.
And a lot of our fans have said that that they always found someone that they could connect to on the show. So there was, because of the diversity, there was strong females. So it was something that had a good message for and people could connect to, I think, as well.
Yeah, what she said.
What's your favorite Zord from what season and why do you like it?
Yikes, that's a difficult question.
I always liked the Red Dragon Thunder Zord because he could fly. And that was my Zord that I manned, so it got to fly through the air, which I thought was pretty cool.
Which one?
Pterodactyl!
I didn't do pterodactyl.
Oh,
I was
right.
The crane.
Oh, the crane, that's right. Okay,
yeah, crane and Thunder Zord. White Tiger Zord. I don't remember.
White Tiger Zord? I shared
one with Tommy.
Oh, did you?
I don't
remember
which one it was.
That's funny. I don't even remember that either.
Educate us on that stuff.
So some of that
crane.
Stuff is. Yeah, crane? Okay, that's all good.
To be a Power Ranger, and what do you have to do
You got to eat all your vegetables.
Mm-hmm.
You got to learn, go to school and do well in school.
Listen
to your parents. No, I'm just kidding. I think just trying to be a positive role model for everybody, that's something that you've got to be mindful of even when your cameras aren't rolling, you know? So that's kind of, I think, probably the most important thing.
Yeah, it's a big responsibility.
Mm-hmm.
We took it very seriously, not just in front of the camera, but even the producers and everything were very aware of our personal life and what messages we were sending out so that we were a good example for you guys.
Yep.
The most recent big screen version of Power Rangers, I think, you know, connected with some fans, but I think there was a general feeling that it was maybe a little...
Too serious?
A little too serious. I'm curious, did you guys see that, and how did you feel about what they were trying to do with that film?
Yeah, well, I mean, you know, when they think about the general message of Power Rangers, you know, it's like they were right on in the sense that together we are more. It's all about teamwork and learning how to overcome something together and learning how to come together to do so. That part of the message of the movie was good, but Power Rangers is also about campiness and it's also about action-packed, you know, and they think they waited a little too long for the action. So hopefully when they do the sequel, Hasbro's taken over now, so I'm sure they're going to do a fantastic job with that. And I think it's going to be a lot more action-packed and something we'll really look forward to. So
I think just as a general moviegoer, I really enjoyed the movie and I enjoyed the take. It was kind of a Breakfast Club meets Power Rangers a little bit. And I liked that they were outcast kids as opposed to being...
That part was good, but I just just think it just took too long for them to learn how to come together.
Yeah,
you know, and that's what you know made the movie drag a little bit.
Yeah, but just if you just look at it as a general movie, I thought they did a great job.
There was a fan made, a darker, grittier.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
I don't know if you saw it yourself, but for someone like myself who watched the original series, the series, obviously being at the age now, there was an interest.
Yeah.
Maybe of they have grown up. This is they are an adult now. What's your thoughts on maybe some sort of your own characters as adults and
right. Well, as you know, that one was with James Vanderbeek, was my character, was Rocky, you know? So I thought it was pretty good. And I'm actually friends with Adi Shankar, who's the guy who produced that whole thing. He's got all those bootlegs that he does, bootleg mm-hmm. things he puts up on YouTube, and they're phenomenal. So personally, on a personal note, I liked it a lot, you know? It's not the Power Ranger message mostly, but it's a good take on, you know, what... you know, could have happened to some of those guys, you know, once the Ranger glory was over, you know? So I thought it was interesting, but...
It was very well done, but again, Power Rangers is a children's program. It's still on the air, and that was a little irresponsible in that way, that it didn't kind of honor the wholesome part of Power Rangers. But I really liked the production value. I thought the cast was great and all of that. And I think they're trying to explore the darker side, the stuff that you guys might have imagined or had questions about in the comics. Boom is doing a really good example with Shattered Grid and all these mm-hmm. different dimensions. So you get to kind of have your fantasies come to life and see where things could have gone. Yeah.
Being such a big inspiration for so many people, what do you think about people cosplaying your character?
I'm always so flattered.
That's a huge honor. I mean, there's nothing more flattering, I think, you know, than people trying to emulate you. So that's mm-hmm. great. I mean, I get even in real life too, not just the cosplay stuff, but people come up to us all the time and they're like, you're the reason I got into this, or you're the reason I got into martial arts, or mm-hmm. you're the reason I became this because you helped me through a hard time in my childhood, you know, like those things to us are always like so mm-hmm. special. Yeah. And we're just so happy to be a part of that and to be able to receive that from people now, you know, is really cool.
Years
later. 25 years later. 25 years later, right?
25 or so. Yes.